what's going on, everybody? Welcome to a budget build, well, Thursday, budget build Friday on a Thursday. But welcome, everybody. It's so good to have you here. Very glad to be back. This is the $875 budget build. It's all AMD, it's all red, so I know you guys have been asking about that. Okay, here we go. Let's go ahead and put and start with our CPU for this build. We're gonna be using the Ryzen 5 5600. This is the non-X, this is the Ryzen 5 5600. This is a six core 12 thread, 4.4 gigahertz max boost, 3.5 gigahertz base. It also has our cooler in it. So that's gonna save us a little bit of money right there, so we didn't have to spend any money on a cooler. And this thing can absolutely handle anything that this chip can throw at it. For our motherboard, we're using the B550 Phantom Gaming 4. So this is the Phantom Gaming 4. We believe we have two M.2 slots on this. For RAM, it's been a while, guys. It's been a while since we have used ourselves some Alloy RAM. It's been a while. We actually way back in the day, back in the humble beginnings of Robitech, used to use a number of Alloy kits. Back when Newegg, it wasn't a sponsorship, but it was kind of like the first RAM company was like, hey, let's just send you a bunch of kits and you guys can try a bunch of it. Now we do that with Kingston, Patriot. Now we have a number of different companies we do that with now. Alloy, kind of one of the early supporters, so it's actually pretty cool to see them come back. We also have the MP404L. This is a Team Group 1 terabyte NVMe drive. It is a Gen 4. You're probably gonna see this power supply a lot. Because we use it a lot. It's a good power supply. It's the Thermaltake Tough Power 750 watt PSU. It's fully modular. It is ATX 3.0. And then for our GPU, I know everybody's excited about that. This is the Radeon RX 7700 XT, 12 gigs of VRAM. The other thing that's actually really nice is that this can not only do 1080p for $875, but it can also do 1440p. This actually slots sideways, like so. Okay, and you just slide it down like that. It's very actually easy to install, but the big difference is that the Ryzen is facing off to the side versus what you're used to. So it's just a little bit different. Here we go, guys. There we go. Working out the fingers. Wow, that was not anywhere close to 98. It was 94.5. It was, okay, here we go. Next one. It's pretty mushy, guys. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. 95.6. All right, let's get the case done. Let's get the case stripped. This is the PG-13 part of the show. Okay, here is our case. Okay, there it is. Oh, guys, we have a little back peel right here. Ready?
When you're at an eye doctor, is it any clearer now?
There you go. Woo! Oh, hold on, I gotta call my wife. Gotta call my wife, guys. We gotta call the wife. She's calling. We gotta call her back here, real quick. She's calling, guys. Here she goes. Let's give her a call. Here we go.
Hello, I forgot forgot you were streaming.
Al's Morgue, you bag him, we tag him.
What?
We're streaming right now. And they want me to tell you a dad joke. And that is, what do you call a fish with two knees? What do you call a fish with two knees?
What?
A toonie fish.
Oh my gosh, that's terrible.
A toonie fish. Oh, pull that off. Don't be scared, it does come off. You just have to have a lot of power and a lot of strength. Okay, so now we take this right here. This is our back panel.
Rectangular spot down here.
It just clips in really nicely. It's actually very easy. And now we're gonna do is we're going to take our motherboard, we're gonna set it down, and we're gonna slide it right in, and it's gonna go right into those same slots. You'll know it's correct. Gonna start up here at the top. There you go. We're gonna take this cable that we routed right here. We're gonna connect it right here next to, that'd be kind of cool. We're gonna actually connect it right here next to the CPU. It says CPU fan right there. Okay, that's gonna cover that. There's our front panel plugged in. Plug it in right there, okay. So those are those two cables. I'm gonna pop that in right there. Right at the top there, there's a little slot here. Okay, it slots right in there, okay? And screw that in. So now the next part, guys, is actually our PSU. Okay, so we're gonna take this out, little case. Give it, guys, you gotta give it a solid sniff, okay? You know what I mean? Just, ooh, it's another, okay. Oh, whoa, yeah, that's stinky. Grab our PSU. So we're gonna take one of these, plug it in right here. This is the one that's dual PCIe cable. And we're gonna take our CPU cable, which also is dual, that's crazy. Take our dual CPU cable, and they say, it says CPU on it, right? Which is actually pretty neat. That's gonna go right here. Okay. Then we're gonna take our 24 pin, and that's gonna go right here. Just like that. And then all of our cables are plugged in, that's it. This is just gonna slide right in there. Just like that. You're gonna line it up just like that on the bottom. Okay, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna start each corner, just like that. You can tighten them all down. We're gonna run it right up here to the corner, just up here, just like how I have it, okay? So that's gonna go up there. And we've actually split one off. Then we're gonna take our 24 pin right here, okay? That's gonna go in this large hole right here, through the bottom slot, and that's gonna go right here, okay? So there's all of our cables run. You're gonna take this, plug it right here. You're gonna take this other one that we made, plug it in right there, okay? Okay, let's go ahead and start putting it back together. There we go. This slides right on. And there we go. It looks super clean. Let's see how this bad boy does from a temp standpoint. There it is. It's gonna stay 7980 under load, but let's let it finish one round just to see. Not overly loud at all. I mean, it's definitely, you can definitely hear it going, but it's pretty quiet. If it was sitting down or away from you, you would not hear this build. And there you go right there. Score was 8,600 points. But, you know, it's not like a beastly CPU or anything like that, but still there. So here's just to give you an idea, Fortnite and low, it's 401 frames per second at 1080p, 319 at 1440p. For Apex Legends, 307 frames per second at 1080p, and we're looking at 232. Again, these are set for competitive settings. For Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, this is balanced. We have no ray tracing. This is just raw performance. 202 frames per second, and then 157 at 1440p. For Hogwarts Legacy at Ultra, 173 frames per second at 1080p, 151 at 1440p. Cyberpunk 2077 high settings, no ray tracing, 112 at 1080p, 74 at 1440p. Far Cry 6 at Ultra, 111 at 1080p, 99 frames per second at 1440p. Forza Horizon 5 at Extreme, again, no ray tracing, 105 frames per second at 1080p, 96 at 1440p. Blackmouth Wukong at high settings, 87 at 1080p, 65 at 1440p. Starfield at high, 73 and 54 at 1440p. And then Homeworld 3, I know we tested this like 50,000 times, it just ended up being the same between 1440p and 1080p. So yeah. And then let's just check thermals real quick with what gaming thermals might look like. So we'll open up Cyberpunk 2077. Okay, we'll go to 1080, we'll go to 1440p, go to full screen. There we go. We're gonna run custom. High, well, we can do high. We're gonna turn, let's try it with this frame generations off. So I have everything on high. We'll see what this does. With ray tracing is not off. We're gonna turn, let's turn scaling off. So we have ray tracing off. We have basically, okay, there we go. Ray tracing off, everything else at high. Hit apply. I'm hoping so, yes, for sure. Okay, guys, so there you go. Anyway, guys, that is it for me. Have an absolutely amazing night. Thanks for watching. See you later, New York. Bye.